Okay guys, back again here with that Chevy. Before we got a heater problem, auto sensor, now we got another code. So we're gonna find out which one is it. I'm going to use my Verus and hopefully I don't got enough glare here that you guys can see this good. Okay, it's a 2008. And it's Silverado. And it's a 5.3. And the VIN code is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. VIN code is 0. And we're going to the engine diagnostics. K17 is my key. I got it here. My personality key is key 17. Continue. Codes menu. Code display. Corrient codes. We got the 3425. I don't know if you guys can see it there. Cylinder 4 deactivation solenoid control circuit. Okay, so basically what I'm gonna do here is go in the data pits and see what option, what functional tests I got. I can feel the misfire on the steering wheel. Let's go out to our freeze frame data. You got 2 freeze frame data. Okay. Coolant was at 125. Map. Engine load 35. TPAs indicate 13%. I don't trust that desired TPS here. TPS here should be 8 or 7%. So, let me go here. TPS here was 16. All right. So let me get out of here. And I want to see my data. Functional tests. Injector balance. Module output. Output control, let me see what I got in output control here. Cooling fan, engine life, evap. injector disabled, yes or no. And I was reading about this code, and when that is active, they disable the computer, disable that injector. So I want to take a look of that to see. And set the band parking and start and idle. AC should be remain off. We got that okay. Continue with this. And I want to see what is my data here. I'm gonna go to custom data here, cause deselect all. And I want to see the injector here. I want to see the percentage in that guy too. And desire idle injector. Where's my injectors? Only one bank injector here, I see. Injector one. Injector bank 2. That don't tell me not much. See the fuel trims, short term, this and this. Press OK. Let me see what I got here. Out of that, I want to see something else here. Let's see, injector balance. Turn the ignition on. The engine must be off. Exit that. I cannot do that. So I see that at this place here. Engine data, misfire data. Let's go to misfire data and see that misfire number 4. What I got here. Man. Cylinder 4 okay, injector okay, and I know that solenoid worked with the number 7 and 4, the one that the activation misfire in 7. So everything say okay here, and this car is misfiring. This car got a misfire. And everything show okay here. That's not nice. Sensor data. Seeing sensor data here. Close, close, close. This is only missed. Let's see, evaporate rich. No. That's not good. No use for that guy. Filtering data, ignition data. So, let me see this guy. Okay. Okay. There we go. This is what we want to look out of here. Okay, so cylinder is okay, okay. So cylinder open. CKT status. Okay. So cylinder 7. You see, guys, I was talking about cylinder 7. And the code is say, the code is say to check cylinder 4. But over here in my data is cylinder 7. That solenoid run 2 cylinders. So the guy here is cylinder 7. I don't know if you can see that. You see, you got a fault here, cylinder 7. So our guy here, history, map low. What I got? 7, okay. And what I got here, 7, 7, 7. Where are you, guy? All right, so it's gonna say okay here. Okay, the command. Okay, this is what you wanna see. When I command it on, you wanna watch this now, guys. Hopefully this data is good. Okay. Command it on. Okay. Hopefully it's not on. Yeah, I got the code on again. He don't let me do the test because he got, let's go to code menu, display code, Gaussian code. No? So what happened there? Functional test. Output control. On and on 7. Change list. Go to this guy. Apparently, he don't let me do it because the computer seeing short to status. Okay. See, what do we got here? Come on, guys, let's see if we can get this on. Continue. He don't let me do it, guys, because he got the code in memory somehow. Let me see if that is true. Too smart, these computers. Display data, code menu. Code display, history code. Yeah, we got a history code. So let me clear this history. Korean code. back, back. Clear coat, engine on, key on, engine off, yes. Continue. Let's see, display coat, history coat, there we go. Now we can do it, guys. But let me get to that point before we go into functional tests, we go into output control, we go into where was that? Cylinder 7 deactivation on and off. We're going to data list, change data list here. We're going into cylinder deactivation data. And we're going to start this engine, hopefully, but let me get these data pits here first. Command solenoid. Let me see. Short to ground. Deactivate solenoid. Not run. Okay, we're going to do this thing. And after I start this car, the history, why we need the history? I don't think we need the history. Let me see, deactivation, solenoid short, not run. We're gonna see now. And then we're going to this guy here. Ready to rumble. All right, we are live here, and I gonna command this guy on. Look at the misfire, guys. Off. I'm gonna command it on. Command it on. Look at the misfire, guys. But I don't see this data changing here, guys. When I command it on, this is supposed to change from on to off. I don't see nothing changing here. And this guy is not bringing me a fault. What's going on here? Watch this pit here. Watch that pit, it say off. I'm gonna command it on. Nothing changing. Off. Deactivate, on and off. Deactivate solenoid. Command on and off. This say not run. That's not good. This supposed to change. That's supposed to change, guys. All right, let's see. Exit out of that, and I'm gonna do the number 4. Change that list. I'm gonna check here, number 4, command, deactivate solenoid, on and off. and solenoid status. Okay, I'm just gonna select these two guys, and I'm gonna do number 4 now to see what it does. Guys, I don't know what is going on here, but this data is not changing. When I got this guy and off, but when I command it on, that guy should turn on. I'm gonna select another cylinder. I'm gonna select the number 6 cylinder. Change data list. Six cylinder status, okay. Six cylinder short. Where is six cylinder command? There we go. Okay, six cylinder command on. You see, guys, that's what it's supposed to do. Off. Now I am concerned here. Now I am concerned here, guys. When I do that, my computer and data should change the command. And take a look at it. I'm gonna do it again here, guys. Look, on. Look at my pit here. Immediately turns on. I'm gonna turn it off. Immediately turn off. And then other 4 and 7 is not doing that. So now I'm concerned here with software and computer problem. Not solenoid problems. This is the good thing about bidirectional scanners. Okay, bidirectional scanner make you do test, and right now here I got a big question mark, because I test number 4, I test number 7, and when I command it, you can feel the engine that is command, but you don't see the data pit changing here. So that is a big question mark. Okay, guys, thank you for watching. I get back to you for this case, but I gonna do one more cylinder. I don't wanna do number 1 cylinder. This will be very big here. And let me see if I can do number 1 cylinder. Deactivate number 1 cylinder. I did 6, 4 and 7. Go to change data list. Cylinder deactivation data. And we're gonna select number 1 cylinder now. And we're gonna select number 1 solenoid. Not run, that's a good data to know. And solenoid command. Alright, guys, so I'm gonna turn it on. Alright. And I'm gonna turn it off. And look at, guys. So that is the story about this thing. Okay, so that guy is working. Exit out of that. I'm gonna go number 4. That one is not working. I wanna see in number 4. Number 4, where is data? Number 4 here is this guy. I'm gonna put this guy here. The command, and I gotta select this guy. Okay, on and off. Deactivation on. Engine misfire. Nothing happened, guys. Nothing happens there. And the engine is misfiring. Okay. So that one is not working, and number 7 is doing the same thing. Number 7 is doing the same thing. Number 7 is doing the same, exactly the same thing. And on for the number 7. No changing in the data. Nothing. 7 and 4. Exit out of this. Seven and four, okay. Let me get to my okay, let me get to this here. 7 and 4. Cylinder 2 and 4. 7 and 4. 1 and 6. This is the way it's wired. So 7 and 4 control. So this solenoid, my question here, why is the engine misfire and no data pits is changing? That's my big question there. Okay, guys, I gotta see more information about this, guys. Because if the solenoid is not working, so of course you don't gonna change electrical. This is electrical solenoid, so it will not change the data. I get back to you guys. Thank you for watching.